Starting us off at number 10, we have Kazam, otherwise known as Shaquille O'Neal. For any of you who have seen that movie, man, oh man, I rewatched it recently and I do not think it holds up. But if there are Kazam fans watching, please let me know what you think down in the comments. Anyway, back to Shaq. Shaquille O'Neal was born March 6, 1972, and little did his mother know, she would be giving birth to one of the most famous basketball players of all time, as well as a modern giant. Shaq clocks in at 7 feet 1 inch, which is 2.16 meters in height, and has quite the list of hilarious pictures comparing his size to other popular celebrities. One of my favorites is a picture of him with A-list comedian Kevin Hart. We all know Kevin is a shorter guy, but next to Shaq, he looks like a tiny villager. Luckily for Kevin, Shaq is just one large friendly giant unless he's on the court. Shaq no longer plays basketball, but is now a sports analyst on NBA related TV shows, and even though nowadays he's usually seen just sitting at a desk, this man is still a giant. At number 9, we have Anna Haining Bates. Born in the Canadian province of Nova Scotia back in August of 1846, Anna was just like every other child until she started a bit of a growth spurt. A growth spurt that never ended. By age 5, she was already 4 feet 8 inches, that's 142 centimeters, and weighed over 100 pounds, that's over 45 kilograms. Finally, at age 22, she came in at 7 feet 6 inches, that's 229 centimeters, and weighed 350 pounds, which is 159 kilograms. Bates went into show business around the age of 16 and would often be shown opposite to a little person to show the incredible difference in size. But being that tall has its disadvantages. In July of 1865, Anna almost burned to death during a fire at the famous P.T. Barnum Museum. The stairs were engulfed in flames and she was too tall to jump out the window. Luckily for her, she was saved by other museum employees who broke through walls to escort her out and was then assisted with a crane. That's crazy. It's hard enough sometimes getting emergency crews to the scene, let alone a crane. But hey, I'm guessing they didn't have the same kind of Toronto traffic as we do nowadays. Anna then later went on to marry another giant by the name of Martin Van Buren, aka the Kentucky Giant, who was 7 feet 3 inches tall. She later got pregnant with 2 children, but they both tragically died at birth. Anna herself later died in 1888 at the age of 41. At number 8, we're going back to the NBA with a basketball superstar, Yao Ming. This famous NBA superstar was born September 12, 1980 in Shanghai, China. Yao Ming's height is an incredible 7 feet 6 inches or 229 centimeters. This giant featherless being has a wingspan of 226 centimeters, which is basically just as tall as he is, and his feet are size 18. Those aren't shoes, those are frickin' water skis. Before coming to play for the NBA, he played for the Shanghai Sharks in the Chinese Basketball Association, and was then drafted to the NBA in 2002 to the Houston Rockets, where he there played until 2011. In February of 2017, Ming was elected as the chairman of the Chinese Basketball Association. Now, there is also a documentary titled The Year of Yao, filmed during his rookie year with the Rockets, as well as a book he co-wrote with NBA analyst Rick Butcher, titled Yao, A Life in Two Worlds. So if you want to get to know him a little bit more, check those out. If you want to see how this giant dominated the court, I'm sure you can find tons of old Rocket games all over the internet. At number 7, staying in China but going back to the 1840s, we have Chang Yu Sing. Sing grew up to be 7 feet 9 inches tall, which is 236 centimeters, and was appointed as a member of the Emperor's court. Later on in his life, he left China for England on what was only supposed to be a brief visit, but that brief visit ended up turning out to be a 2-year stay. During his stay in England, many people would stop him and pay 3 shillings just to see him. Later on, taking advantage of the extra cash, he went on tour through the rest of Europe and was shown off alongside another little person just like Anna Haining Bates. He later also joined P.T. Barnum's circus and was also known to have many female admirers. By the sounds of it though, none of them lasted because I could not find any info on whether he was actually ever married. Maybe he just liked the bachelor life too much. I get it. Anyway, Chang Yu Sing later passed away in 1893 and his funeral was only attended by 50 of his closest friends due to his own wishes. His coffin was 8 feet 5 inches long, that's 260 centimeters, and I don't want to imagine what it was like being one of those pallbearers. If I was one of them, I probably would have let him down. At number 6, we have Patrick Cotter O'Brien. Patrick was born in Kinsale, Ireland on January 19th, 1760. He grew up to be 8 feet 1 inch tall, which is 244 centimeters, and he was the first of 13 known people to grow past 244 centimeters. At the age of 18, he worked as a bricklayer. Needless to say, unlike the rest of his bricklaying colleagues, he did not need a ladder to reach the top of the cottages that they were working on. After he had enough of bricklaying, just like the most of the other giants on my list, he went into show business where he later went just by the name of O'Brien. He traveled around in a specially made carriage and apparently he was once stopped by a highwayman who, when seeing the giant O'Brien inside, immediately ran away with his tail between his legs. His massive weight took quite the toll on his body, which brought him to his death on September 8th, 1806 at the age of 46. I'm sure his weight caused him many troubles and struggles, but I bet it wasn't easy for the horses pulling him in the carriage average either. That being said, the more horses, the easier it is to pull an 8-foot tall giant. That's the old saying, right? Coming in at our halfway point at number 5, we have another Canadian, Joseph Edward Beaupre. Joseph was born in Willowbunch, Saskatchewan on January 9th, 1881. His parents were what was considered average height, and honestly, so was he until the age of 3, and he started growing like crazy. By the age of 9, he outgrew his own parents, and he was 6.5 feet tall. At the age of 17, he was so big that it is reported that he lifted an 800-pound horse. I don't know if that's true or not, but if it is, then that means he was not only tall, this guy was yoked too. He reached his full giant potential at the age of 23 at 8 feet 3 inches. That's 251 centimeters. He had to wear giant custom-made shoes that were size 22. If Yao Ming shoes are water skis, then these are freaking snowboards for each foot. He had dreams of becoming a cowboy, but gave up because his feet would still touch the ground while atop his bucking bronco. He later joined a circus as well, as hoping to capitalize on his size, but it took its toll on him, especially because he suffered from tuberculosis. He sadly died on July 3rd at the age of 23. Now, this story gets pretty sad. After his death, the circus refused to help his father pay for the burial, so his body stayed with the undertakers, who then started displaying his corpse in store windows and museums. In 1907, his corpse was found in an old circus hangar and was then given to Montreal University, where it was mummified and stored. In 1970, Ovilla Lesperance, descendant of Joseph, requested her relative's body back, but was at first denied because the university didn't want his body stolen and put up for display again. Finally, Ovilla got her relative's body back, and Joseph was cremated in September of 1989, 85 years after his death. Even though his circus employers and maybe the Montreal University people are now deceased, I still have one thing to say to you. Screw you guys. At number 4, we have Arthur Cayley. Arthur Cayley was born in Sulby, Isle of Man in 1824 and was considered a normal-sized human being until his late teens, when he started growing much, much taller. Maybe it was an after effect of puberty. He reached 7 feet 11 inches tall, which equals to 241 centimeters. He weighed over 392 pounds, which is 178 kilograms. His size earned him the name Manx Giant, and he was known to be a bit more wide than his other giant friends as well. He was frequently seen in exhibits in Manchester, London, and Paris before suddenly and mysteriously disappearing. His mother reported that he was dead, but many doubted this because his life had been insured for 2,000 pounds only a few weeks prior. They believe it was a case of insurance fraud and that a tree was actually buried in his place. Sure enough, Cayley was not actually dead. He traveled also to join P.T. Barnum's circus, and he was known as Colonel Ruth Goshen, the Arabian Giant. His former life as the Manx Giant stayed a well-kept secret until his death in 1889. At number 3, we have Angus McCaskill. Angus was born on the island of Burnet in Scotland back in 1825. The Guinness World Record books recognize him as the tallest true giant to have ever lived because his height was not caused by any kind of growth abnormality. Funnily enough, he was so small at birth that doctors didn't believe that he would survive. Now, Angus only grew to 7 feet 9 inches or 236 centimeters, which may not seem like much after a few of our friends on the list here, but trust me when I say this guy was still absolutely massive. He had the biggest chest ever, coming in at 203 centimeters or 80 inches around. He weighed in at 500 pounds. That's 227 kilograms, in case you wanted to know. Oh, and by the way, he could lift a 2,800 pound ship's anchor. He was also known to carry a 100 pound weight, which is 45 kilograms, for 10 minutes using only 2 fingers. Angus often received requests from people wanting to wrestle him. If those challengers didn't have the same size as Angus, they most certainly had guts. He then, of course, later joined the circus and toured through Cuba and the East Indies until going to Europe and North America. After retiring from the circus, he went into real estate and opened up his own store. Sadly, in 1863, he died from brain fever. Can you imagine rolling up to a house and seeing this guy out front? The outside is perfect and beautiful, but I don't know a damn clue what it looks like on the inside. Can you let me know? At number 2, we have Bernard Coyne, aka Bernard the Giant. Original name, huh? Bernard was born in Anthon, Iowa on July 27th, 1897. His actual height is cause for dispute because some report him being 8 foot 2 inches, while others say he was 8 foot 4 inches, while even more people saying that he was 8 feet 8 inches. No matter what though, he was over 8 feet, which is over 240 centimeters tall. He was so tall that he was actually rejected by the army, probably because they could see him coming from miles away and that they were too scared that his rations would need to be 3 times the size of anyone else's. Unlike most other giant people whose height is a result of abnormalities in the pituitary gland, Bernard's height was from the unicoidal infantile gigantism, a very rare syndrome. His parents would put him on display for extra money when he was younger, but later decided against it because they didn't want to be on the receiving end of the wrath of God. Good idea, jerks. Bernard preferred a quiet life and turned down countless offers to go on exhibit ever again. His shoes were a size 24, which means they're considered something, I don't know, bigger than a snowboard, and he weighed in at 300 pounds, which is 136 kilograms. He sadly passed away at the age of 23. Man, being put on display for a couple of extra bucks by your parents. Too bad child services were not around yet. And finally, coming in at our number one spot, if you ever visited Clifton Hill on the Canadian side of Niagara Falls, you'll know this guy. Robert Wadlow. Robert was born on February 22nd, 1918 at a normal size. However, he quickly started growing at the age of 5 and he was already wearing clothes intended for teenagers. At age 8, he was taller than his 5'11" father and could even carry him up the stairs. He then joined the Boy Scouts at age 13 and had to have his own uniform, tent, and sleeping bag specially made for him. In 1936, he joined the Ringling Brothers Circus as a curiosity. He had a huge appetite and ate around 8,000 calories a day. In case you're wondering, the average human eats 2,000 to 2,400 calories a day. Damn, that guy can eat. He unfortunately suffered from some leg issues and had to wear leg braces and also often use a cane, but nevertheless, he kept growing. Sadly, one day, one leg brace was fitted improperly and ended up causing him a huge blister on his ankle, which then became infected. Tragically, the infection killed him at the age of 22 on July 15th, 1940. He was last measured June 27th, 1940 at 8 feet 11 inches, which is 272 centimeters. He was a true giant, and not only was he actually missed, but so is his Niagara Falls statue at the Guinness Book of Records Museum. I remember countless trips where I actually measured myself up against him, and that was a lot of fun. Miss you, Robbie.
Starting us off with number 10 is the Titanoboa. Now, there were so many pronunciations to this one, I was like, what do I choose? But then Charlotte over on IO said it was like that, so I'ma trust her. Titanoboa. I'ma trust her. Now, I'm sure you guys have all heard about this creature. This now extinct reptile was monstrous and the largest, longest, and heaviest species of snake that ever lived. They could grow up to 50 feet long and weigh up to 2,500 pounds, which is no joke. And it wasn't even their weight or length, they were just thick. Like with two C's, like they weren't skinny snakes, they were girthy. And thick. They were mostly found in present day northeastern Colombia and date back 58 to 60 million years ago. Now, they spent most of their time underwater or around the trees, and their dull coloring allowed them to be super camouflaged very, very easily. Their diet consisted of giant crocodiles, turtles, birds, and basically anything they fancied eating that day, because they could. They had rows of teeth lining their upper and lower jaws, and since they weren't venomous, they would either constrict their prey or block their windpipe. Now, no one actually knows why the Titanoboa went extinct. One theory is that it was due to climate change, which, I mean, great, because it's gonna happen to us as well, so we'll be right there with you. Either way, let's not bring back this enormous snake, because I'm surrounded by too many snakes already. Can't deal with anymore. Mic drop. Coming in at number 9 is the Spinosaurus, also known as the Spine Lizard and one of the largest carnivorous dinosaurs to ever exist. It was dubbed the Spine Lizard because of the giant protruding spine it had that sort of looks like a fish's dorsal fin. These creatures existed about 112 to 93.5 million years ago and were found in present day North Africa. They were bigger than the T-Rex even and could grow up to 40 to 60 feet in length and weighed nearly 21 tons. They were the biggest out there in terms of diet. They mostly ate big sea animals like sharks, swordfish, lungfish, and crocodiles. Since it's literally called the Spinosaurus, obviously I have to talk about their spines, like come on. Their neural spines were more than 5 feet long, which let them move in the water very easily, sort of like a sail. Now, their dorsal fin was mostly dense bone and it was used to absorb heat, store fat, and regulate body temperature kind of like a camel. Like, what is this dinosaur? It's a camel-fish hybrid, but bigger than a T-Rex that could kill you and your whole family in a second, so it's like, I'm getting a lot of mixed signals right now. I don't know what to think. At number 8, we have the Andrewsarchus. The name of this one is just so funny. Like, Andrewsarchus, like it sounds like the final boss of those frat boys that will sue you. And now you must fight Andrewsarchus of Delta Upsilon Chapter Boss. Anyway, now that I'm done on this creature, let's actually speak facts. This creature existed around 45 to 36 million years ago in what is now present day Inner Mongolia. They honestly looked like very ugly wolf-hyena hybrids, except just a lot bigger. Their skulls were massive and had snouts attached that basically consisted of 60% of their entire face. Like, its face alone was 32.8 inches long. That's a big face. Based on the skull alone, it was declared the largest meat-eating land mammal to ever exist. They weighed anywhere from 800 to 1,000 kgs and were just huge, savage dogs. Since we've never found a complete skeleton of one, it's hard to tell what the rest of their bodies would look like, but what we do know is that we're at the top of the food chain right now, and if they were around, that's our number one spot, just gone. and we don't need that. Filling our number 7 slot is the Deinosuchus, which literally translates to terrible crocodile in Greek. Now, crocodiles are already scary enough, but just imagine the biggest crocodile you can think of. Yeah, the Deinosuchus was bigger than that too. These creatures roamed the Earth 82 to 73 million years ago and used to live on both sides of the Western Interior Seaway, which was this inland sea that used to divide North America but now obviously doesn't. Despite being named terrible crocodile, they were actually more closely related to alligators. Who the f knows the difference between them anyway? When I was young, I actually thought crocodiles were the male versions and alligators were the female versions of the species, and I don't know any better now. They grew up to 40 feet long and weighed about 10 tons. If you can see this picture right here, oh dear god. Now this is a comparison of a Deinosuchus skull and a regular alligator skull. Does that give you more of an idea of how huge I'm talking when I say this thing was huge? Like, they're not playing around. I feel like my whole body could fit in that mouth. Anyway, in terms of diet, they mostly ate other large dinosaurs, smaller dinosaurs, large aquatic dinosaurs, and turtles. Have you seen the jaw? It could eat my whole family if it wanted to. Nope. Nah, B. We're not getting you back. Bye bye. Stay extinct? No. Now at number 6 is the Dunkleosteus. Now off the bat, this one doesn't look scary, but believe me, it is. It lived on Earth around 358 to 382 million years ago and was actually an aquatic creature. The largest fossil ever found was nearly 20 feet long and weighed about a ton. Looks wise, they were very interesting. They had armored bodies, and instead of teeth, they had two sharp bony plates that made it look like it had a beak. And the face of it really reminds me of a Pokemon that I can't remember the name of. Please tell me if you know it down below. And I know having teeth sounds scarier, but don't be mistaken, the Dunkleosteus could open and clamp its jaw closed in as little as 50 milliseconds, and their bite force was 612 kgs at the tip and 755 kgs at the edge. Their beak was essentially designed to break into the same kind of armor that covered their own bodies, and that means they were either cannibalistic or they fought each other for territory. Either way, we never trust a hoe that eats its own. Never ever. No, no. If you betray your own, what are we gonna do with you? In terms of diet, they ate anything they encountered in the water, to be honest, and the other fish would have just seen it coming, and the dude's beak would have already opened and closed and just KO before you even know what's going on. You're done. It's bitten your head off. Unlucky. Too slow. You snooze, you lose. Coming in at number 5 is the Haast's eagle. I know we still have other species of eagles around, but this one really takes the cake. These eagles became extinct after 1400 and were mostly found in the South Island of New Zealand. In Maori folklore, the Haast's eagle was accepted and looked at as this monstrous bird. It was the largest eagle to ever grace the earth, and they were even larger than the largest living vultures. They grew large because their prey, the flightless moa, was massive and could grow up to 510 pounds, so I mean, you need to be big yourself if you're gonna eat and kill something of that size. Let's be real. Size wise, they're about 22 to 33 pounds with wingspans of 8 to 10 feet, and that doesn't seem that big because, I mean, it wasn't. However, it lent to it being fast as hell, and they would attack at speeds of up to 80 kilometers an hour. Now, the force of its attack would be the equivalent of a concrete block falling from an 8-story building. Specific, I know, but I mean, it would literally pierce the out of its prey, and it's even said that it used to pick up Maori babies and kill them. This bird is out here abducting babies. No remorse whatsoever, stone cold killer. You can't have that around the kids. It's gonna suit me away in a second. At number 4 is the short-faced bear. Now, I've never actually seen a regular bear that's not extinct, but from what I've heard from everyone at the office, they're absolutely lethal. Which I never would have thought before, because the bears are usually very cute and cuddly, but no, these mofos will run after you and kill you, dammit. So with that in mind, the short-faced bear existed up until 11,000 years ago, so I mean, it's the most recently extinct one on the list, you could say. They were found mostly in North America, California specifically, and their faces aren't actually shorter, they just have deeper snouts and shorter nasal regions than other species. But that made their bite force more lethal than any normal bear, including grizzlies. Either way, these short-faced bears were humongous. The largest one ever weighed 2,110 pounds. Like, what? What? An average one would be 8 to 10 feet standing up, but the larger ones would be 12 feet standing and could run at speeds of 40 miles per hour. Like, these bears are no damn joke. Diet-wise, they were omnivores. They would eat basically depending on availability, but they needed 35 pounds of meat a day, so if they existed right now, we'd be like a free-walking stir-fry for them. Just pick whichever one you want, eat it up, chase after it. Doesn't matter. 7 other billion of us, eat us up, it's fine. We can take the hit. We're overpopulating anyway. Filling our number 3 slot is the Smilodon, more commonly known as the saber-toothed cat. Now they were around up until 10,000 years ago, so they've now taken over the bears as the most recent animal on this list, and they overlapped with early humans. They were found mostly in the Americas, and they were more robustly built than any other feline. They had incredibly developed forelimbs and long-ass upper canine teeth, and the longest recorded being 11 inches. The bigger ones were about 500 to 900 pounds, and the smaller ones were about 350 to 650 pounds. The saber-toothed cat was a hypercarnivore, so I don't even have to tell you what that means. And on top of that, they hunted in packs. So let's just say if they existed, we definitely would not. Okay. Now at number 2 is the mega piranha. Come on you guys, piranhas are a real threat. And a mega piranha? Say less, my friend, say less. Now they were around about 8 to 10 million years ago and swam around the region of present day Argentina. They were bigger than the piranhas we have now. They were about 28 inches long and weighed 20 to 30 pounds. The ones we have now weigh about 2 pounds, so you can imagine the difference. They're just babies. They're just not mega, let's be real, they're beta at best. Either way, they ate things like crocodiles, snakes and fish. Like, can you imagine this little fish eating a crocodile, which back then would have been huge as well. The mega piranha could exert a force that was up to 50 times its own weight, meaning it could crush a car in its mouth if we were to experiment. And honey, if it's crushing a car, it's crushing your skull. End of story. And finally, at number 1 is the Megalodon. I feel like there was absolutely no doubt or contest about what number 1 was gonna be. The Meg, you guys. The Meg. Meg, Meg, Meg. Dun-dun. Dun-dun. I hope you liked my performance. That is what a current day Megalodon would act like and be like. Now, none of the animals on this list would win against the Megalodon, and they're all already apex predators in their own right. The Meg was around 23 to 3.6 million years ago, and to simplify, it is the biggest shark you could possibly think of. They reached up to 60 feet long at the largest, but even the small ones were still 35 feet long. Their bite alone could exert 11,216 to 18,500 kilograms of force. Their teeth would straight up just break your bones. For comparison, great whites attack from the soft underside of their prey's bellies, whereas the Meg would just break through the chest cavity and puncture the lung, like we're just going straight for the jugular. The bigger ones would eat things like whales, seals, and sea turtles, whereas the little ones would eat smaller whales. I already have such a massive phobia of sharks, you guys know this if you've been watching for a while, I barely go into any body of water already, but if scientists brought back megalodons, I would never step into the ocean again. I don't even give a damn. Even if they were only found like 1,000 miles away from me, I would still not step into the ocean. Like, if those things came back, that would be the start of the end of marine life. Like, it's over for us all at that point. Sea travel, not a thing anymore. Cruises, bye bye. Scuba diving, sayonara. Me? Gone. Somewhere in the ether. We're not here anymore.
Okay, starting off at number 10, like we always do, we have the Megatherium. This animal is also known as the giant ground sloth, and they were one of the largest terrestrial animals that ever lived on this planet. They measured in at about 20 feet in length, but they were a slow moving herbivore, so animals didn't really fear this creature. Early humans in South America hunted this massive creature, and they hunted it to its extinction 10,000 years ago, or did they? In the deep jungle of South America, there are so many tales about terrifying creatures who stands at 10 feet tall. They have enormous backward facing claws and thick brown fur. All of these characteristics are consistent with the Megatherium's description, so maybe these aren't just stories. Next up, number 9, we have the Mastodon. These hairy creatures are prehistoric relatives of the modern elephant. Mastodons have tusks, floppy ears, and a long nose, which is very similar to the elephant. Mastodons appeared on Earth about 27 million to about 30 million years ago, primarily in North and Central America. They typically stayed in the woodlands areas or sometimes around valleys and swamps. They apparently went extinct about 10,000 years ago, and most of the theories say that they went extinct because a lot of the scientists believe that the Earth warmed up too quickly from the Ice Age for the Mastodon to adapt to, or that humans hunted them to extinction. So although they went extinct so long long ago, a man named David Ingram described seeing creatures twice the size of a horse, hairy, and in the shape of an elephant. He accurately described what a mastodon would look like, and he said he saw them while he was traveling to the United States. There are even other people claiming to have spot these creatures in modern times. Next up, number 8, we have the Japanese wolf. Japan used to have two species of wolf that used to live on islands. Biologists consider the Japanese wolf to be extinct, however, there are a ton of rumors circulating of people seeing them in the wild regions of Japan. These two wolf species became extinct in the late 1800s and the early 1900s due to rabies, loss of habitat, and hunting by humans. Despite their extinction, a Japanese wolf was sighted in 1910 and then in the 1930s and then again in the 1950s. If that wasn't enough to convince you that these creatures are still alive today, there have been a ton of sightings in the 1900s. Skeptics believe the humans are mistaking a hybrid wolf dog for the Japanese wolf. That's definitely a possibility, but what if the Japanese wolf was still alive today? Pouncing in at number 7, we have the Javan tiger. They are a relatively small tiger that is as tall as a Great Dane. On the island of Java in Indonesia, this was the home of the Javan tiger, but as humans occupied more and more of the island, the Javan tiger was forced to move to the uninhabitable parts of the island. They were hunted by the humans so they could make more room for farming, and unfortunately, by the time the government stepped in to preserve their species, the tiger was already too far gone. However, many locals have spotted Javan tiger claw marks and footprints, and they could still be alive because they are excellent at hiding and avoiding humans. Also in 1995, a Javan forester discovered a large group of these tigers still living on the island. These sightings continued into the early 2000s, and people are still finding evidence that the species still exists today. Swimming into our number 6 spot on our list, we're talking about the Plesiosaurus. This is apparently an extinct marine reptile who lived approximately 135 years ago in the Jurassic period. They have long necks, thin bodies, wide flippers, and small heads. They have very sharp teeth and incredibly strong jaws, so they're able to feed on any fish that came in their path. Creatures matching this description have been spotted all over the world in lakes and in oceans. A lot of people believe that this animal exists, and people are just calling it the Loch Ness Monster. It is actually possible that these animals survived and they're just living in the depths of the ocean where humans are unable to explore. If this Plesiosaurus still exists today, that would also explain why people have reported seeing sea dragons from around the world. The Tasmanian tiger leaps onto this list at number 5. This species is also known as a thylacine, and they were a timid and a nocturnal creature who was considered to be a major pest and a dangerous threat to livestock. They look similar to a medium or large dog, except they had a stiff tail and an abnormal pouch, kind of like a kangaroo. The government set up a bounty system between 1888 and 1909 in order to get rid of these species. So people went all over Australia killing the Tasmanian tiger, and they officially went extinct in 1936. Or did they? Since its extinction, there have been many sightings of the Tasmanian tiger in Tasmania and Australia. It has been spotted so many times that a lot of people really believe that the Tasmanian tiger still exists today. Here's a clip that was taken in 1973 proving that these animals might still be alive. Take a look at this. Marching in at number 4, the woolly mammoth. This would be amazing to see this alive today. These creatures were closely related to the Asian elephants. Woolly mammoths look a lot like them, except for a couple major differences. They were covered with a thick coat of brown hair to keep them warm in the frigid weather. Even though the woolly mammoth went extinct around 10,000 years ago, we have a lot of information about them because of the permafrost in the Arctic preserved their bodies and left them in almost perfect condition. But what if I told you that these giant creatures might still be roaming the earth? There are a lot of people who have claimed that they saw a woolly mammoth in the modern times. In the late 1940s, frozen mammoths were discovered with fresh meat still in their mouths, and every once in a while there are stories all over the internet of people claiming that they've seen an elephant creature with thick fur. Take a look at this video I have for you guys. A Okay, so a man filmed what appears to be a woolly mammoth in Siberia. So what do you guys think? Did a woolly mammoth go extinct 4,000 years ago, or could they still be alive today? The Beijing dolphin comes onto our list at number 3. The Beijing dolphin, or the Chinese river dolphin, is the first dolphin to be declared extinct in modern times. This is just incredibly sad. It is the first large mammal species in 50 years to have gone extinct, and it was solely due to mankind. This animal was declared extinct in December 2006 due to harmful fishing practices such as the use of gill nets, rolling hooks, or electrical stunning. There were efforts put in place to save this species, but none of them apparently worked. But even though there are thought to be extinct, a Beijing was spotted in 2007 by a team of researchers. Unfortunately, there was only that one sighting since the extinction, but it's still possible that these dolphins might still be alive today. Stepping into this list at number 2, we have the mysterious Bigfoot, otherwise known as the Gigantopithecus. Their fossils indicate that they were the largest known primates that ever lived. They stood at a height of 3 meters, or about 9.8 feet, and they weighed as much as 540 to 600 kilograms, which is about 1,320 pounds. I mean, damn. Now, these are one creatures I don't know if I want to be alive today, because they're pretty terrifying. However, scientists almost knows nothing about this mysterious ape. The first piece of evidence that this ape existed, it was discovered by a German paleontologist who found a large molar. Okay, so get this, it was dubbed as a dragon tooth. For years, this was the only trace of this ape, but since then, researchers have found dozens of teeth and a few partial jaws of the Gigantopithecus. It is believed that this giant creature went extinct because the forest shrank and they weren't able to find enough food to survive and reproduce. But some people believe that the Gigantopithecus survived and evolved into Bigfoot. The two creatures look very similar, and there have been many people reporting that they have seen this mysterious creature. Okay, so topping this list, in at number 1, we have the mighty Megalodon. This species of shark was the largest to have ever lived. Paleontologists believe that the Megalodon was capable of growing up to at least 52 feet, which is 3 times as long as the longest great white shark ever. No one knows for sure what the Megalodon looked like, because all that remains from the prehistoric monster are some teeth and a few vertebrae, but paleontologists are able to make a very educated guess. Originally, the Megalodon was believed to be wiped out by global warming. However, there have been many sightings all over the world by fishermen and sailors who have claimed to see this large shark. That couldn't be the great white shark, because it was way too big. There was also a fossil of the Megalodon tooth found deep in the ocean, which means that they still might be living in the deep sea, and occasionally they come up to the surface. I mean, after all, there's still 95% of the world's ocean that still hasn't been explored, which is insane to me. All I know for sure is that I would never want to have an encounter with these beasts. Imagine surfing, and then bam, the Megalodon is right there behind you. Yeah, your lunch.